Hey guys, this is Shayan, and in this video I wanna talk about how to get to experts on Codeforces. In case you don't know me yet, I'm Shayan, an IGM in Codeforces and also an ICPC World Finalist. And why am I someone to tell you about this? Well, if you take a look at my account in Codeforces, Shayan, you will see that in a short period of time, from March of 2015 to June of 2015, I had a great improvement. And I went from newbie to expert. And today I want to share it with you that what did I do exactly and how can you do it as well. This is something that I always tell to my students too. So grab a pen and paper, write these points down because these are gonna help you significantly. Let's start. First, solve problems around your own rating. Well, you know that if you solve very easy problems, they're not gonna help you much to improve. And also if you solve very hard problems, it's gonna take a lot of time from you and you cannot solve a lot of problems. I believe that in order to get to experts, you need to solve a lot of problems. I myself was solving like 10 problems a day. If you look at my account, you can see that in that period of time, I was solving like 10 problems a day. And by definition, they were not so hard. Even though thinking a lot on problems are gonna be very helpful in future, but since you're just beginning and you want to reach experts, I believe that in this period of time, the best strategy for you is to solve problems around your own rating so that you can be able to solve like 10 problems per day. I believe that these problems should have the difficulty such that you spend like half an hour on them in average.
At that time, CF didn't have difficulty for problems.
Yeah, right.
So I sort problems by number of people who accepted these problems, and I solve first 5 pages of problem set sorted right by number of accepted.
That is really the best approach. Yeah. I always tell the beginners, my students, to do this first. I always tell them to go first solve 400 problems from the easiest problems, and then we will talk. Don't start learning complicated data structures, etc. Yeah. Just go and solve problems, implementation problems, brute force problems. Yeah, math, exactly. That is the best approach.
Yeah.
So for instance, if your current rating is 1200, I believe the best difficulty for you to solve problems from is around 1200. As I said, the reasoning behind this is that you need to solve a lot of problems. If you solve very hard problems, you have to think a lot about them. By spending a lot of time on very hard problems, you will spend a lot of time thinking, but very few time coding. And that's why after a while you see that you're good at thinking, you're good at solving problems, but you're not good at implementing them and you cannot accept those problems. That's why I believe that you should spend your time on problems around your own difficulty at this stage. Don't go for very easy problems and don't go for problems harder than your current level. Some people might say that, but if I spend a lot of time solving problems on my own rating, will my rating increase? Well, yes, but when your rating is at some point, it doesn't mean that you can just solve and implement all of the problems on that rating. Maybe in some of tags you're better, in some tags you're worse. And the point is that when you solve problems around that those rating, you will find your weaknesses as well. You will see that from your own rating, what tags are not really as good as that rating, and you will be able to solve those problems too. Two, don't distract yourself with irrelevant materials. If you have watched my two other videos on how to get out of newbie, you will see that I said that you should not learn very complex data structures like segment tree, centroid, etc. when you're a newbie. But that's always true. But the only difference is that now that you want to reach experts, you have to do more topics. But still, there are topics that you don't need to work on a lot. For example, I still believe that complex data structures are not needed. Instead, you have to focus on something else that I will tell you on the next point. So the point is that irrelevant material is not only the materials that are not useful and they will never come in competitive programming contests, but also the material which are harder than what you need are also relevant. Sometimes I see that people who want to get to expert spend their time to learn persistent segment tree. Well, that's stupid. You should never do that. So focus on problem solving around your own rating. Do not spend time to learn algorithms which are extremely hard. 3. DP, DP, and DP. Well, one of the most important topics in competitive programming is dynamic programming. You have to spend a lot of time on that, especially when you want to get to expert. That's the time that you have to spend a lot of time on dynamic programming. So try to work a lot on dynamic programming, the different ways of dynamic programming, etc. If you have watched my topic streams and learned DP from me, you know that dynamic programming has four different phases that you have to be careful about. And I told you how to approach dynamic programming problem. So make sure that you are completely okay with it and you have comprehended it, and try to solve a lot of problems from dynamic programming as well. On those problems that I was telling to you that you have to solve like 10 problems a day, include dynamic programming problems as well. So other than solving just tag-free problems around your own rating, which are extremely helpful, try to also solve problems with tag dynamic programming too. 4. Watch the topic streams. I have prepared a lot of free topic streams for you in which I have told you how to approach different topics like dynamic programming, graph theory, number theory, etc. They are completely free and they are designed for people like yourself. So I strongly recommend to you to watch them to completely understand and learn these topics. I will put their link in the descriptions below so you can watch them and start learning from them. After watching the videos that I have learned the topic, for example, let's say dynamic programming, watch the video that I solve problems in it as well. So make sure that you will use these materials, especially if you don't have a teacher right now or you're not very satisfied with your current teachers. 5. Think as much as needed. So a very important question is how much you have to think about a problem. I have also asked about it to many great competitive programmers as well that you can see in my interviews. Like I have asked Omnik and Reina and many other people. We all agreed on the same thing. You have to spend time as much as you're not stuck. If you still feel that you have ideas to solve the problems, you have to keep thinking on it. Don't spoil the problem right away. But I and the people that I interviewed did believe that, especially in this stage, when you feel that you're stuck, it's okay if you look at the editorial, for example, read the first line and see that what does it say. Get a hint from it and continue thinking. And even if it's not enough for you, you can continue reading to see that what the solution is.
There's always problems that you haven't solved. And I do think you should just go look at the solution always.
Indeed.
You should look at the solution.
So how do you think we should approach problems? I mean, how much you should think before going to start seeing the solution?
I think if it looks like you need to know something that you don't,
right.
Maybe like start reading like line by line and thinking
mm-hmm.
it. But as a general rule of thumb, you don't want to just like see end to end of the problem. Like read it like little by little, the editorial, mm-hmm. and think again.
6. Learn as you solve. So as I said, you don't need to learn a lot of algorithms to get to expert. You have to solve a lot of problems to get to expert. That's the main point. Solving problems is the important thing, not memorizing what the algorithms are. So the approach that I highly recommend, and that's what I did as well, is to learn as you solve problems. Well, I used to do this. I was not reading editorials. Well, to be honest, at the beginning, I didn't know that editorials exist. I was just new to Codeforces and I didn't see that tutorial button. So I was reading people's codes and I learned a lot from reading other people's codes. I learned how to code better and I also learned some new ways of thinking as well. The way that I was using was to opening a code and trying to understand what is it doing. And it helped me thinking as well. After a while, sometimes I were realizing that that's actually an algorithm. So the point is, I never tried to learn an algorithm. I was trying to solve the problems, and as I was solving them, when I was seeing that there's a problem that needs something, I was learning that while facing that problem. So I was not learning an algorithm before actually facing a problem that needs that algorithm. So that's what I recommend to you as well. Try to learn algorithms as you solve problems. Don't start first learning and then solving problems. Just start solving the problems and you will learn. And the most important topics that to get to expert, as I said, is like dynamic programming, greedy algorithms, number theory, graph algorithms, and still the topics that I told you in newbie videos. implementation, brute force, math, etc. Initially, you were a specialist when you started writing contests in CF. After around 2 years, you became a red color. So, and you said that everyone can become GM. So what was your practice method in that time so that people can also do that and maybe they can also reach Grandmaster?
I solved a lot of problems. That's it.
How long you were solving problems per day or per week?
I don't remember, but well, basically all my free time.
All your free time. 7. Don't be afraid of contests. Okay, for now I'm not participating in contests because I'm not good enough. But I'm gonna train and work hard, and then after a while I'll start participating in contests. But that's not a good approach. As you see, I participated in all the contests as well back then. Also see this part from Alireza Kavyani, the Iranian LGM. So there's also another question from Codeforces, and it's saying that what difference you did compared to others, such that you believe that it had significant effects on your improvements.
I always trying to never miss a contest in Codeforces.
Never miss a contest.
I didn't miss any single contest in years 2018 and 2019.
Wow. Why? How?
Because I really enjoy it.
Right.
Do you miss a date with your love?
No.
No.
So at the beginning, it's very important to participate in all the CF contests. It also boosts your motivation as well, seeing that rating goes up and down. It helps a lot. So try to participate in all the contests that are going on. Don't be scared like, oh my god, I'm gonna lose rating. It's okay, lose rating. You will go up back again. Try to participate in all the contests, and if in a contest there's a problem that you really believe that you had to solve but you didn't, after the contest, spend more time on it. We call it upsolving. And try to upsolve that problem. Upsolving helps you a lot to improve. And not only participating in the contests, but also try to have virtual contests as well. Codeforces has this feature of virtual participation that you can choose on any Codeforces contest. You can choose it and then you can start having a virtual contest. So it's gonna be exactly like a normal CF contest. You are gonna solve the problems, you don't have access to the solutions or anything. It's like you are really participating in the CF contest, but in a virtual way. The contest has been passed, but you are gonna participate in it in that limited time and you have to solve the problems. Participating in virtual contests and upsolving the problems that you haven't solved during the contest helped myself a lot. So I believe it's gonna help you a lot too. Okay, how to see the tutorials or read other people's codes? Well, for example, on this problem, you can find the editorials here. Also, when I prepare video editorials for Codeforces contest, you can find the video editorials by me as well that I have explained each of the problems. You can also see other people's codes by clicking on this link and then click on this number. And then you have access to everyone's codes. And the very good point about it is that these codes are sorted by their sizes. So the first code that you will see here is the smallest code. So you can learn a lot on how to write shorter codes and how to implement better. Because some people might have a lot of work to do the same thing that could be done with a shorter code. Okay guys, that's all with the 7 points on how to get to experts. These are the things that I did myself as well. Well, definitely except watching my own tutorials. And in both cases, when I did it and when I tell my students to do this, it always works well and people have massive growth in their rating. I show it again. You can see that only in 3 months I could get to here having ranked 4 in a contest of Codeforces while I'm an expert from being a newbie. So when it works for me, it definitely works for you as well. Now I have a task for you. In the comments below, write your current state. What is your rating right now and in how many months you want to get to experts. And when that time was passed, for example, you said that in 5 months, I'm gonna be an expert. When 5 months passed, Just reply that comment and say that how did you do this strategy and how did it work for you. I believe that if you really do this strategy, you will get to your goal. That's all. I hope this video helps you. If you learned something from this video, please like it. And also, you're more than welcome to join our communities by joining our Telegram channel and Telegram group. You can find the links in the descriptions below. See you next time. Shayan.